Everybody, it's Evicta. It's time to continue the streak here in the Binding of Isaac Evicta Afterbirth Plus series. Thank you, everybody, for getting the like streak goal on the day before yesterday's video. Over 6,000 likes. I've retroactively gone back and awarded the extra mark on the like streak. Thank you all very much for that. And I'm not feeling any better from yesterday. I have been resting my voice as much as possible. I did record a Pokemon episode earlier, so, you know, expect that. And, yeah, here's your meme of the day brought to you this time around by Contextual Dodo, who sends in this beauty of a meme. Sinvicta-sama, Krampa is war. Krampus is war. I don't want to give you a devil deal. My chance is 100%. Krampus. I don't know what anime that's from, but thank you very much, Contextual Dodo, and everybody who upvoted that one. Let's hop on in and look for win number 830. Okay, see, today's going to be X, 3 X-Ray Quebec, Carly 7, Keelison. We have so many repeating characters that threw me off. Also, broke my brain. Also, starting with Curse the Blind and Guppy's Tail, along with the Golden Teleporter, which is also known as Teleport 2.0, which is actually the correct name for it. We got great tears, terrible damage, good shots, excellent shot speed. Kind of bad movement speed, but it's to be forgiven given the fact we're starting with an 8-tier delay and 1.24 shot speed. I will take that. And 3 HP as well, which is kind of nice. So we just sit back and relax, folks, because we got ourselves a Golden Teleporter run. So what is the Golden Teleporter? What does it do, and why does it matter? Well, the Golden Teleporter is a very unique item in Isaac. It is potentially one of the best support carry items in the entire game for a spacebar item in particular. So what does it do? Teleport 2.0 will take you to a room that you have not been into yet, and that includes all rooms on the floor. And yes, when I say all rooms, that includes Devil Deals as well as the I Am Era room, which is the ultimate prize to get from the Golden Teleporter. That's what we're going to be going for. So, how do you get to the I Am Era room, and what does it all mean? Well, to get to the I Am Era room, you have to understand how the Golden Teleporter works. If you do not explore and do a full clear on the floor that you're currently on, you will not get to the I Am Era room unless if you have a ton of full charges on the ground. Now, I'm very happy that we already got this one here, because chances are, especially with this bomb now, that we are going to be able to get into at least the secret room, although this floor, for a floor one, is a really wonkily laid out floor. There's a certain order of operations that the Teleport 2.0 works off of. It will prioritize just regular rooms first, like the one that we're in right now, then go to special rooms like the shop, the item room, then go to challenge rooms like, you know, mob trap rooms, boss trap rooms, and after that it will go to the secret room. So you're guaranteed to get into either the secret room or the super secret room after using, this is assuming that you've cleared through all of the normal rooms and not gone into, and also gone to the boss. So, assuming that you've killed the boss and you didn't get a devil deal, the priority goes secret rooms, and then the devil deal, and then the I Am Era room. So in other words, you need to be able, in order for you to guarantee at least a devil deal, you have to have found the secret room and the super secret room on any given level, on top of doing a full clear and the boss. Then you can guarantee a devil deal, no matter what. Now, I'm not going to lie, I don't exactly know where this regular secret room is. I know where the super secret room is, which is right here. I was really hoping there's going to be another bomb in there. So, but there's a problem. As you see here, we need to get into the store. If we don't get into the store, we don't have a chance of getting into the I Am Era room. So the secret room, I think, is north of here, but it's impossible for me to really know that. I could take a huge risk and open up this golden chest, remembering it's Curse of the Blind, or I can guarantee that we at least get into the devil deal by just walking into the store, which is what I'm going to do. So even though that wasted our key, the fact that I was able to find the super secret room, this guarantees us a devil deal no matter what, because the first time I use the Golden Teleporter, it's going to take me to the regular secret room, and then after that, it's going to take me to the devil deal. And because we have that full charge, that means that we are able to guarantee go into the devil deal after Ragman, assuming we don't die to Ragman, which is definitely possible. In fact, if I wanted to go to the secret room now, I could. But I'm not going to, because we have to fight Ragman. So it prioritizes normal rooms, special rooms, boss room, Secret Rooms, Super Secret Rooms, Devil Deal, and then the I Am Error Room. The I Am Error Room will always be last. Always, always, always. Unless if you're in the chest or the dark chest. Then you don't get an I Am Error Room. So what's the trade-off? What's so good about having the I Am Error Room? Well, the I Am Error Room is a huge incentive for us because it accomplishes two things. The first thing it does is that it gives us more items. It gives us a chance. It's not a guaranteed item, but it gives us the chance to get more items and have more control over our run. And, of course, if we have that kind of option, the more options that you have, the greater the chance it is that you win. You can get more powerful. You can get more money. You can get whatever. So the I Am Error Room benefits Isaac in a multitude of ways, and it's not that hard to get into as long as you have enough full charges on the ground or if you're sufficient enough at finding secret rooms, which, of course, we are. Well, at least I am sometimes. So the first one we're going to go here is going to go into the regular secret room. We got money, which is good because now we can buy a full charge. If there's one in the store, we can buy this full charge, which will allow us to go into the I Am Error Room. Now we're going to go to the Devil Deal. But before we do that, I really want to get a Soul Heart. Because if there's two Heart Devil Deals, I will only be able to take one. Let's see what's in the Devil Deal. There's exactly three Soul Hearts in here. Or three heart deal. Okay, so this is where we gotta be careful here. We can take this down to 1.5 hearts. Yeah, it won't pay out with anything else. I'm going to take the two heart devil deal, and it's going to be Brimstone. Wow, Brimstone's been showing up a lot lately. Now we can buy this full charge or go to the I Am Error Room. We can buy this full charge, or we can buy this bomb. My point is that I'm thinking about buying this bomb because this could potentially give us a soul heart to have, but then we're sacrificing our ability to get the I Am Error Room. I'm going to have faith in Brimstone and just go to the I Am Error Room. Funny game. Yeah, sometimes you have to deal with this. The I Am Error Room is not ironclad going to help you. So unfortunately, unless we get a... Nope. Unfortunately, we didn't really get a whole lot of benefit out of here. But hey, we got Brimstone on floor one. I'll take it. Okay. Things are a little bit dicey, not gonna lie. A little spicy. That's what the kids say. But with Brimstone, I have confidence that we'll be able to at least get our HP back. I hope anyway. As long as we don't get insta-gibbed in the room that we walk into like a Mullaboom or something. But that would kick off this week. I mean that would just be the perfect bookend to a pretty awful week for me. That's right, poop has me hopeful. So the petrified poop is going to hopefully produce us a heart or soul heart, or at least get us into the store so we can buy a soul heart. And this was the risk that we kind of took. I didn't have to use those spike chests, obviously. But again, it's about assessing risk and having faith in what the game gives you and your personal skill level. The reason why I'm so composed right now is because I'm not worried about dying here. It's gonna have to take a screw job of monumental proportions for the game to kill me with Brimstone this early on in a run. Like I would have to screw up majorly for that to happen. And I ain't worried about it. Fortunately, there's no Soul Heart, though, but there is a full charge in here. I will take Mom's Key. Mom's Key means that we just have more chances to spawn coins. If we happen to get ourselves a Sackhead or whatever, we will be able to open it. If I open it, I mean get more full charges to go into the Imera room. Okay, so there's a tinted rock here. Before we go into the boss fight, we should go clear out this big room here. That full charge there, as long as we find the secret room, guarantees us access to the Devil Deal. Not that we need the Devil Deal right now, because obviously we've only got, you know, one HP. Looks like there's an arcade on this floor as well, which we only have 1 cent to get into. And one bomb, which we can hopefully use to get into the secret room. But we already have our deal with the Devil Precedent, and that's really the only thing that we need to be concerned about. It does really suck that we didn't get a soul heart in the store. I cannot tell you how much that sucks. And right now what I'm looking for is I'm just looking for confirmation of the secret room. It could be there. It's so hard to tell though, man. Because like with this room here, it's a crapshoot. It literally is a crapshoot because we don't know. I don't know if it's there or if it's in that other spot. I could also just use... Let's do this. I think the safest thing to do is to use this bomb on either the slot machine and or Three Skull Monty. Three Skull Monty is bound to drop us something. So we're going to go fight the boss and use this High Priestess card. There's no red hearts that I can see, so unless the boss gives us HP, we're probably not going to be able to take the deal with the devil. Fortunately, we just missed that tinted rock, and we get Judas's freaking shadow. Okay. Judas's shadow coming alive for us here in our time of need. Big time play, son. Okay, so the first one's either going to take us to the IMR or to the secret room or super secret room. Fortunately, we didn't find that in time, so now we're forced to go into the secret room and hope that there's enough money to buy a full charge. So we're going to head on down. That's a pretty big disappointment, but we are Black Judas, we do have Brimstone, and we're very powerful. And curse the XL. Well, I'm glad that we got stat ups on that last floor, because man, we needed them. Now, something I haven't been talking about yet is the fact that we did start with Guppy's Tail, so I need to be careful with our key usage and not spending your... Not being too frivolous with our key spending. But with 1224 damage here, I mean, we're gonna be looking pretty. We need to get our HP under control, though. It's really, really unfortunate that we didn't get either of those tinted rocks on that last floor. And Guppy's Tail was the whole reason why I ended up going for... I was so adamant about getting Mom's Key is because we have Guppy's Tail. And why that matters is because, obviously, if we're spawning more chests thanks to Guppy's Tail, the more benefit that we get out of opening chests, which means that the potential for us to offset our key usage is greater with Mom's Key than without it, when having Guppy's Tail. Not exactly sure what's over there, but play it by ear. Wow, that shot traveled so far to get to our feet. And again, there's no full charge in here. Or not full charge, but there's no soul heart in there, which is becoming increasingly annoying. I'm I'm liking the amount of bombs that we're getting, though. That is nice. I'm not sure why we're getting so many, but... I'm not going to use this key to open up the item rooms yet. The reason being is because we still have other rooms to clear, and we may find a golden chest. By golden chest, I mean golden key. I also have no idea. I mean, we've got plenty of bombs here, but I have no idea where our secret room is. So what you can do about the mob trap room and boss trap rooms, you don't have to complete them in order for them to count to teleport 2.0. You just have to simply walk inside of them. Okay. Let's go into the item rooms, I guess. See if we can get an HP upgrade or something in there. Gives us a tears up and a fear shot. I mean, with a 30 tier delay, that's kind of whatever. I was really just kind of hoping for really anything that could give us HP here. I'm still reasonably upset to the fact that retaliatory bomb fly shot hit us. We got plenty of money here. But this is the downside of having to do full clears, is that you obviously you're putting yourself in harm's way when normally we would have already like pieced on out of here. But we got to get a key to get at least inside of our regular secret room, or not secret room, but our item room. In order for us to do that, we got to have some more Yaves, and we're not getting chests here. Finally, thank you. So let's go check out the other item room real quick. See if we can get an HP upgrade. There's no arcade on this floor either, which kind of stinks, because we could have used a fortune-telling machine. I mean, just one soul heart is all we're looking for here. The Fuel Duplex does not give us the soul heart. Also, it doesn't really affect Brimstone. Neither does Robo Baby. Epiphora. I'm gonna use money right now, because money is something that we have a lot of. So we'll take Maggie's bow, just to have a little bit of HP and some breathing room here. It's not ideal, but I mean, honestly, with us being Black Judas, we don't really need stats at this point, especially with Brimstone. We just needed HP just to prevent us from walking on, thin ice here. Super Secret Room is most likely south of here. Not there. We should open these two chests. And you're seeing here, it's really inconsequential for us to do these extra rooms just because of our massive amount of damage that we have. And that's the reason why you can afford the luxury of being, just be cool, be calm, collected, focus on making good dodges, good decisions, and don't take any risks. Don't take any risks when you're walking the thin line between life and death and Isaac. Secret room is guaranteed to be south of here, so I'm glad that we came up here, because now, because we found the regular secret room, we're guaranteed to get into the Iomera room, just based on the amount of full charges that exist on this floor. And we haven't even finished it yet, so most likely the super secret room will be up here somewhere as well. Thank God we got a Yave. Super secret room may be north of here. Sometimes it is, sometimes it isn't. Is not this time. Okay. So I'm going to save myself a whole bunch of time and just use the Golden Teleporter 2.0. Pretty odd how Bighorn perfectly dodged that Brimstone shot by just simply hesitating for a second. A blue cap, which is going to give us a nice tears up. Shot speed down, but who cares about that? But more importantly, of course, it gives us HP. A pentagram, which is going to give us even more damage thanks to us being Black Judas. Okay, so all we have to do now is just find the regular secret room, and then we've got We've got the Devil Deal, which we missed, of course, but we got the Devil Deal locked in. Super Secret Room could be here. It'd also be here, but highly unlikely. It is there. The first time I've ever seen it spawn on that room, I think. Okay, so now that we've been in and out of there, we can get this full, this first full charge. This will take us guaranteed into the Devil Deal. Which is as predictable as it could be. Hence the meme. Public Coal is great. And then last, and certainly not least, we will finally go into the Shopperino. Now, I wouldn't have to do this had I not been lazy about using the full charge, but do me. So thanks to the Curse of the XL, we've missed two guaranteed Ayamara rooms. And also a guaranteed Devil Deal because we've got Teleport 2.0. So fun times for all. And then of course we get the trolliest of troll air rooms, but the point is, I guess, is the whole reward is the journey and not what was actually in or not in the air room, I suppose. Which was nothing. So we have two red hearts and I believe half of a soul heart. By the way, shout out to Mongo Baby. Great to see you. Sack of pennies. Always a pleasure. Super secret room. No, it's a regular secret room. Interesting. Thanks to us having Magic Mush and Roid Rage, our movement speed is out of control right now. Super Secret Room might be north of there. I'm willing to look a little bit further on this side of the map. We can get a read on where it possibly could be. But that's the terrible thing about XL floors is just the fact that whenever you do have a run, especially with the Golden Teleporter, because it is so guaranteed, if you are sufficient and able to find all secret rooms, like if you just have the ability to, it's like, man, we just lost out at least on guaranteed Devil Deals. Yo, Mongo Baby. Come on now. Come on, Mongo Baby. I've never had a problem with you, bro. You've always been Mon Bro Baby. Let's take out the boss real quick. We might as well. Squeezy, which is going to give us another Tears Up and two Soul Hearts. And, yep. I don't really want Contract from Below. Well, Contract from Below could have helped out, I guess, but I mean, it's Necropolis 1, and we're not going to have a store after this, and we're not gonna, I mean, we may fight Hush, we'll see, but the reason why I didn't take it is because I think that this HP is going to be worth a little bit more to us than by just simply taking Contract from Below. I'm going to make a deposit while we're here. There we go. Okay, so we still need to find the super secret room. And I think that's it. Because we've already been to the Devil Deal, obviously. And here's to hoping that the IMR room will stop making a liar out of me and actually, like, you know, show people why you're important to get. Like, I wanna give some value to my boy the Teleporter 2.0, you know? What you're doing right now is the exact opposite. You're kind of just trolling and laughing at us. All while, like, you know, my voice is going out. Not that I would ever expect Isaac to have a heart or anything, but, I mean, Isaac does have a heart, and we see it quite often. Isaac humor. Okay. I will take Contract from Below, then, if given the chance. This will take us to the Super Secret Room, which will have an Eternal Heart. And then we can go back, buy the full charge from the store, and that's guaranteed to take us to the Ayamara room. And what lies inside? We'll see. Sometimes the bosses that spawn in the Ayamara room can actually drop other items. It didn't, but sometimes they can. Also, bombing the bombing I Am Error can sometimes give you Steam Sale. But it didn't. All right. Yeah, that golden teleporter's Invicta. Woo, you showed us. Man, that's such a great item. So happy we get to show, like, you know, all these full clears for such a phenomenal item. Great job, Sinvicta. Sinvicta. That's how Four Strategy Gaming says my name. Now, this is definitely in my top 10 least favorite I Am Error rooms. Thank you, Force. All right, go check into the arcade here, and we might as well get a little bit of extra money. Not that we've had money problems, of course, but if there is a challenge room that we need to get into that is a boss trap room, then we will be able to get inside of it. And no, before you ask, you cannot get taken into Boss Rush or the golden door for Mega Stanley. I wish you could, trust me. Unfortunately, there is no full charge in here. There's a Hermit card, though. Very, very weird looking floor. Speak of the devil. The contract from below makes double. It basically, anything that spawns that has a chance of spawning will spawn doubly. It's either going to spawn double of what was supposed to spawn or nothing. That's why it says price, but at what cost, or double, but what at what cost, something like that. The contract from below can be good. It can also be not so great. But most of the time, contract from below is pretty good. If you get that comboed with something like, say, Mom's Key, for example, or Humbling Bundle, then you know you're rolling in cash at that point. Here's our regular secret room. Thank you, Demon Judgment. Double so hard, I'll take it. We don't really need money anymore. Oh, really? One of you still alive up there, huh? Apparently, I missed. No, do not want Taurus. Not only does Taurus kind of disrupt the flow of gameplay, it also makes you super slow. And I know that we have 2.0 movement speed, but I just don't like Taurus. Now, if you're wondering how come we healed for 2 hearts there, that was not one heart that was stacked on top of another heart. That was the effect of Maggie's bow. And what Maggie's bow does is it will heal you for double the amount of health that you pick up. Priestess. Now, if I were a smart player, what I would do is I would go back, I'd pick up that Hermit card inside of the store, fight Mom, get the Polaroid, come back out here, and then tap this Demon Judgment till it pays out. But we're not going to do that. But that's what you should do. If I have to, I will do that, but I don't want to. You're going to make me, aren't you? You're going to make me go fight Mom, get the Polaroid, and then use the Polaroid invincibility on you, Demon Judgment, aren't you? Oh, finally, Sinvicta does the right thing. All right, so we'll take the Hermit card. Go clear out to the rest of this floor. Now, we don't know where the super secret room is yet. I have a feeling it's probably going to be relegated to the boss's side of the stage. So just be prepared for that. Again, just stellar damage. I mean, our 16.80 damage is just beautiful. You'd love to see it. Alger's Rune, that would actually benefit us greatly. Let's go back and use the Alger's Rune. That way we don't have to come all the way back and get the Emperor card. And if you're wondering why I'm not picking up any more money, it's because money doesn't matter anymore in this run. We may go fight Hush, maybe. Oh man, I'm glad we didn't miss that. Okay. Also, you may be noticing that Mongo Baby's shot has since changed, and that is Mongo Baby's special ability. Mongo Baby will copy the effect of whatever other familiar that you currently are in possession of with. So, for example, because we have Little Steven, Mongo Baby is going to be shooting out these little Steven homing shots. If we had a little Brimstone, we'd be doing that. Same thing goes for Rotten Baby. Although, I don't know if he can actually copy little Brimstone. I always forget. But Mongo Baby will randomly swap between the familiars that you have, depending on what you have, if he's able to copy their ability. Yeah, so we did not find the super secret room, but we can use the golden teleporter to come back out to go find it. Hope that we get a devil deal here. Not get a devil deal. So this is going to take us to the super secret room guaranteed. And it was actually in that room. So now what we need to do is we need to get a second full charge to get into the devil deal, since we did not get one. And also, ironically, we're gonna have to do all this stuff over again if we want to come back to the shop. I mean, so there is a full charge inside the curse room, and I mean, I think there was one in the store. Oh, maybe there wasn't. So we can only get to the devil deal. We cannot get into the Iamera room. But judging by what we've seen in this run for the Iamera room, the ones that we've gotten, I don't think we're missing much. Oh my goodness. Well, I guess we get to test the hypothesis here. So we're going to take Zack Dagger. We're going to take Guppy's Paw. We'll take Little Brimmy. Then we will take Jake. Ooh, Jake this. Abadabba Ding Dong. We got Leviathan. Yeah, he didn't copy it. That's okay. So we're 2 of 3 for Guppy now. We've got Little Brimmy. Admittedly, Little Brimmy is not in a great spot, but that's okay. I don't think we needed to have flying for anything else, and we don't have a full charge potential anywhere. We already did the boss trap room, so yeah. No problem. So we miss out on the Iamera room. Again, I don't think that we actually missed out on anything, and we'll just head on down. What a run. And another Curse of the XL. Yep. Well, you know that the game is sick of your shenanigans when they give you 2 XL floors in a row. Well, not in a row, but on one run. So, you know what? That's perfectly fine, Isaac. Maybe the game is trying to do me a favor and let me go rest again. That's what I'll choose to believe, even though that's not true at all. Thanks to the treasure map, you can see exactly how vast this level is. We're gonna be on this level for a while. Just sit back and relax. It's going to take quite the journey to get there. I could also just say the heck with it. Actually, now that I think about it, I can say the heck with it, because it's going to be Womb 2 that we're technically on, and that has a chance of not taking us to the chest. But I think I will just go straight for the bosses and just be done with it. But trust me, though, the golden teleporter is fantastic. It was this the crappiness of this run's payouts was not it's not on the golden teleporter, it's on just the error rooms. The IM error rooms that we got in this run were horrible. They're usually worth it though. Trust me guys, they're usually worth it. We do need some more Yaves. I'm not gonna open that. There's our Yaves. Jamjar, a friend of mine by the name of Jamjar Boy, he's a streamer who I like to watch a lot. He called me out on my pronunciation of Yaves. He's a guy who can speak fluent English, Spanish, and German. I'm like, man, how do you even do that? I mean, how does one possess the superpower? Because I would love to learn a second language. I would really love to learn German. German's one of my favorite languages to hear. And Spanish as well. I mean, I'd like to learn a lot of languages, but he did call me out on my pronunciation of Yaves. And I was like, man, I don't know how else to pronounce it. He did not get a double deal with 73%. La 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 la. So that makes a total of 3 devil deals that we have been screwed out of thanks to Curse of the Unknown, or Curse of the Labyrinth, I should say, in one run. That's pretty awful. Now, just picture this. All kidding aside, picture the scenario, and this will give you a better readout and reasoning behind why I talk so adamantly about how bad Curse of the Labyrinth is. Chew on this. Imagine if we didn't have Brimstone and we weren't Black Judas. Think of how many stats we would have just lost out on because the game just felt like not giving us a devil deal. Just picture that. And then factor that into the fact that we've had 2 XL floors. And really quickly, you're able to realize, hey, this is bad. We need to be able to get these stats up. If we don't get these stats from somewhere, you know, we're screwed. And Curse of the XL denies you of your ability to get stats, thanks to how it spawns. You're automatically defaulting on at least one devil deal, at least. And that's why, and the reason why this is dangerous is because if you look at a run like this, where we didn't have so many advantages going into this run by being Black Judas and having Brimstone on floor 1, what would have happened? You know, we have no idea what this run would look like. It would be a much different run, that's for sure. That's how devastating missing entire floors worth of devil deals can be in this game. Same thing goes for the special rooms, same thing goes for the dice rooms, the libraries, the mob trap rooms, boss trap rooms, curse rooms, sacrifice rooms, all that stuff you lose thanks to Curse of the Labyrinth. And we've gotten it twice in this run. So we would be in a much, much worse position than we are in right now if we didn't have the advantages of being Black Judas. I don't know why I decided to shimmy there. I didn't have to. So I am going to go try to get a double deal just to see if we can get Guppy. And we'll use the Emperor card and call it a day. Again, thank you all very much for the understanding and support. It definitely, I talk about it a lot, and I keep echoing the sentiment, but it does make me feel good to know that there are people who genuinely care about my health. You know, if the entire audience was, you know, I'll just shut up and play Isaac, you know, that'd be, it would make things a lot more difficult to deal with, let's put it that way. And I'm happy and lucky to have the mosh pit to back me up on that. So the reason why I used the golden teleporter there was because I thought I had another full charge, but it turns out we don't. And I don't think that this is going to give us enough. Boss trap room anyway. IV bag. Ooh. Now triple charge could send us over. Yeah, triple charge actually just gave us a devil deal. Wow. That was insanely lucky. Insanely lucky. I'm not going to take it. A Thame is great, of course, but I'm not going to... It's not... We don't need a Thame. The only item I would have taken in there would have been either, like, 9 lives or the Pact, or a Guppy item. That would have given us Guppy. And I'm not going to use the rest of our keys, because obviously we've got to go to the chest. We'll head on up for the finale. But I appreciate the support, everyone. I really do. And, you know, this week has been rough, but I'm not the only person in the world who's had bad weeks, and I'm not going to dwell on it. It just takes time to work through stuff. Some days it's easier to work through stuff than others. But we worked through this run, and we got ourselves an easy win. Thank you for watching, everyone. If you enjoyed this video, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Either way, it supports my channel. Subscribe and ring the notification bell so you get notified when my newest videos go live here. Again, there will be a new Pokemon episode coming out later on today, so definitely check that out at the 2 o'clock hour. And then we end up the week with GeoGuessr for the final episode of this week happening at 3 o'clock. So thank you for watching, everyone. Thank you for liking, commenting, and subscribing. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.